how can Pakistan achieve freedom of speech in the country?
Well, I think it's something, you know, Imran Khan really has stressed. It's the importance of good public education system, meaning that not everybody should have to pay for private schools, right? That you have families in Pakistan that don't have the income that can support, you know, putting your children in private schools. And like in other countries, public schools are well-funded and provide the basic education for the population, right? And in Pakistan, they need that as well. They need to better educate the general populace, right? The more education they have, the more they will, you know, demand of, you know, more accountability from government.
What do you think about Imran Khan? Many people criticize that.
Well, I mean, they can criticize all they want, but look at what they've had, you know, past 15, 20 years, if not longer, right? You have no transformational leadership in Pakistan, right? It's been, you know, kind of one corrupt leader after another. And Imran Khan is at least giving, you know, he should be at least given a chance to demonstrate to the people that he can make some sort of difference. I think anything he does, even if it's a little bit, right, will be much better for the Pakistani people than what's currently going on. You know, all you have is really the people at the top deciding who gets what from the government, right? And then the rest of the population suffers.
So is he international figure, Imran Khan?
Oh, definitely. I think one thing you look at is leadership, right? Leadership from the cricket team, right? That leadership transformed into, you know, political leadership. And you could see that somebody that, you know, put his team ahead of himself in sports, right? And he's putting his team ahead of himself, you know, the country ahead of himself in Pakistan, right?
And I think he started the best hospital, cancer hospital.
Oh, yes, definitely. He's done many charitable works. In KP, you look at, he's done so many projects, improved the police system there, he's improved the healthcare system, education systems, put women more in the workforce for the government, right? I mean, the KP is kind of the model of what, improved the police system there, he's improved the healthcare system, education systems, put women more in the workforce for the government, right? I mean, the KP is kind of the model of what he could do for the rest of Pakistan.
And one question, some people say he's pro-Taliban, so...
He's what?
He's pro-Taliban. Is it
true? No, I wouldn't say he's pro-Taliban. What he's trying to do is make peace and come up with a different way, because look at what happens with war. War, we lose people's lives, we spend billions and billions of dollars to get nowhere, right? He's saying that we have to come up with some different approach, right? And anybody, any reasonable person has to agree with that.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Yeah, and if you think of it, look at what the U.S. has spent. $13 trillion on wars in the last 20 years.
So it's not good to spend $13 trillion.
It's destroyed the United States economy, you know?
No, it's not good. Okay, yeah. Thank you.